3.
Thank you.
rotation, but I think your arm started to straighten out too much. So without that little bit of elbow bend, it's harder to turn that wrist. So just try to keep that elbow a little bit more relaxed. That way you can twist it out more that way versus spitting up to that top of the circle.
Thank you. shoulders with the seat.
That way you're pushing and you're already shifted. And then it's just, yes.
Okay.
That way it's not a full reach. Tilt it a little bit more facing the puck, that way it's easier to get that clamp. You know what I mean? Kind of closer to your hip, that way it's on the angle of the puck versus being a little bit open. Shoulders with everything, everything is much better. So just incorporate that shoulder movement with the blocker when you're, you know, shifting towards that puck. Like in your pivot to go slide, like bring the shoulders with it as well.
All right.
Every time you do that, you're more over top and more aggressive coming out.
Gotcha.
Between the speed skin and just like, I got them as stiff as I could.
Yeah.
Those pads, I like them, and I have them, like, I've never worn them. But I know that I would like them.
They slide like a drink.
They look unreal to, like, move around in. Taking up so much room as a big guy,
yeah.
And you're coming out. So yes, you can have that forward tilt with aggressive hands. Just don't be overdoing it to the point where holes open up underneath, because it's harder to come back in than it is to go up for that little bit.
Okay.
Taking up most of that room.
Yeah.
So if you come out and just have your elbows tight but your hands in front, because we don't want to open them up.
Right.
So if your hands are here and they're aggressively in front but you're closed off, then it's easy to make those small adjustments once the shot's fired.
Okay.
That way you're not so upright. You have a little bit more of a forward lean, take an angle away.
Okay.
Last one.
elbows come into play. So, yeah, that was a slide. So, shuffle drop.
Okay.
You may need to drop mid-shuffle, which is fine, but I want you to start the push on your feet and then drop as you're coming over. Sometimes get there on your feet, right? And more times than not, we want to try to do that as much as possible. So as you're pushing, just push like you're trying to get to the puck and set before I shoot it. But I may shoot it as you're coming to your stop, so you're going to have to drop mid-movement or at the tail end of your movement. So you're not going to be able to set that foot perfectly every time. But do the same push, hard push, and then you just need to drop as it's coming over.
So think less both knees, like you're going to probably drop one. Yeah. Yeah. Because it is still a slide.
Yeah.
I'm going to let you do a bunch. And I want you to find out your comfort zone of when and how to drop. Because
okay.
I think if I keep spouting out different ways to do it, you're going to get so in your head on which one to choose. And like, I just want you to feel it and do it.
Okay. It's such an awkward move.
It is.
If you feel like when you see him shoot, you got to stop and then drop.
Yeah, no stop. Just drop.
Because like I know the shot's coming.
That's why I want you to do a bunch and just kind of get the feeling for it and find your groove. Stay over the top. Like you're right? Stay pointed down, just like any other. I mean, this is a high quality scoring chance, right?
Yeah.
So as you're doing your shuffle, it's no different than you would. Trying to get there on your feet, you're still here.
Right.
But as you're coming over, you just need to drop.
Together, probably, as much as possible.
one.
Got caught under you, but